Oil palm, which is botanically known as Elais guineensis, is the highest oil yielding perennial palm, which was first introduced as an ornamental palm to India in the year 1848 in the National Botanical Gardens, Calcutta, from Africa. Organized commercial cultivation of oil palm started during 1972 at two locations, namely Kerala, in about 3,700 hectares, and in Little Andaman, 1.63 hectare. At present, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka are the major cultivators of oil palm. Palm oil also is known as palm fruit oil. Palm oil is sometimes confused with palm kernel oil, but the palm oil comes from the mesocarp, the flesh of the fruit, and the lauric palm kernel of oil from the kernel at the fruit's core. Two oils are separated in the oil palm bunches by the thick shell of the palm kernel. Palm oil is physically refined without the use of chemical solvents, thereby reducing the risk of residue of contamination. Palm oil is reddish because it contains a high amount of beta carotene. It is used as a cooking oil to make margarine and is a component of many processed food. Boiling it for few minutes destroys the carotenoids and the oil becomes white in color. Palm oil is one of the few vegetable oils relatively high in saturated fats, such as coconut oil. Palm oil is rich in carotenoids, that is provitamin A, tocotrienol and tocopherol, that is vitamin E, and it contains no trans fatty acids. Palm kernel oil. It is obtained from the kernel of the oil palm fruit. The oil composition is very different from that of the palm oil. Palm kernel oil contains 48.2% of lauric acid, 16.2% of myristic acid, 8.4% of palmitic, and 3.4% of capric, and 3.3% of caprylic, and 2.5% of stearic, that is saturated fatty acids, 15.3% of oleic, mono unsaturated fatty acid, 2.3% of linoleic, that is poly unsaturated fatty acid, and 0.4% of other acids. Palm kernel olein. Palm kernel olein is the liquid component at the natural temperature of palm kernel oil obtained from fractionation. Palm kernel stearin is the more solid fraction at natural temperature of palm kernel oil obtained from fractionation. Palm kernel oil, palm kernel olein, and palm kernel stearin find uses in margarine, confectionaries, coffee whitener, filled milk, biscuit cream, and coating fats with little or no further processing. Palm kernel stearin is widely used to substitute for the more expensive cocoa butter in many of its traditional applications. Oil press cake, after extraction of oil from the kernels, is used as livestock feed. It contains 5 to 8% of oil. Palm wine, locally called toddy urnia, is made from the sap obtained from the tapping the trunk or male inflorescence. The sap contains 4.3% of sugars and 3.4% of glucose. The sap ferments quickly and is an important source of vitamin B complex. The palm heart, that is soft tissue of undeveloped leaves around the apical bud, is eaten as a vegetable. Let us now see the climate and soil requirement of oil palm. Temperature of 21 degrees C to 32 degrees C is required, with the annual rainfall of about 200 centimeter and relative humidity of 75 to 100% is most ideal for palm cultivation. Palm trees can grow well in the altitude of about 450 to 900 meter above mean sea level. In respect of soil, it prefers moist, deep, loamy soil rich in humus with good water holding or water permeability. Ideal soil pH is between 4 to 6. In respect of varieties, classification within oil palm is based primarily on variation in fruit characteristics. Based on shell thickness, three varieties are classified. The Dura, which is a homozygous with a thick endocarp 2 to 8 millimeter. Tenera, which is heterozygous with a thin endocarp 0.5 to 4 millimeter. And Piscifera is again homozygous without a lignified endocarp. Within the Dura and Tenera types, there is considerable variation in shell thickness, which is apparently under polygenic control. Tenera is preferred as planting material because it has more oil bearing mesocarp 60 to 90% by fruit weight than Dura, which has only 20 to 65% by fruit weight. Piscifera is usually unproductive because female inflorescence abort before developing into fruit bunches, but it is used as male parent in crosses with Dura palms to produce pure strands of Tenera palms. Now we will see the propagation methods. The first one is the nursery techniques. Fruits are separated from the bunches and we have to remove the exocarp and mesocarp with a knife. Dry the seeds on concrete or wooden floor under shade for 2 days and stored for 3 to 9 months. Seeds are soaked in water for 5 days, but we have to change the water daily and spread out to dry for 24 hours. Dried seeds are put in 250 gauge polybags of 23 into 30 centimeter size, filled with topsoil, sand and well decomposed cattle manure in equal proportions and placed for germination. Germination about 90 to 95% can be obtained within 10 to 12 days. Apply fertilizer mixtures containing 15:15:6 of NPK at the rate of 8 grams in 5 liters of water for 100 seedlings. Freshly harvested, cleaned and dried seeds of oil palm with 14 to 17% of moisture content lose viability within 9 to 12 months at tropical ambient temperature, say about 27 degrees C. High seed viability, more than 85% of germination can be obtained for 24 to 30 months in air conditioned storage at 18 to 20 degrees C and at seed moisture content of 21 to 22 degree percentage. To break dormancy and to induce rapid germination, seeds of oil palm require a heat treatment of 39 to 40 degrees C for 60 to 80 days, followed by cooling and rehydration. Practically all planted oil palm are Dura into Piscifera hybrids, which are produced by controlled pollination of female inflorescence on selected Dura palms with pollens from selected Piscifera. Fruits are Dura type, but the palms raised from the such seeds will produce thin shelled Tenera fruits. Newly germinated seeds can be transported over long distances, say 300 seeds in a polythene bag and several bags carefully packed in a box before planting in a pre-nursery in mini polybags, say 8 cm into 20 cm, 200 gauge black polythene. Transplanting into the nursery takes place at 2 leaf stage and large polybags, say size here is 40 cm into 6 cm with 500 gauge black polythene. It is most commonly used. Total duration of both nursery stages before transplanting to the field is 10 to 14 months. Under favorable climatic conditions and ample availability of space and irrigation facilities, a single stage nursery system can be applied by planting germinated seeds directly in large polybags. Shading has to be provided to young seedlings during the first 2 to 3 months. Now we will see the planting and cropping systems followed in oil palm. Oil palm plantations are usually established on a flat or gently undulating land. Where soil permeability is poor, the construction of a drainage system may be necessary. Planting on steep hills require terracing or construction of individual platforms. A leguminous cover crop is often sown after land preparation or soon after planting to protect the soil, provide humus, add to the nitrogen supply and suppress the weeds. Prepare the land for oil palm planting at least 3 months before transplanting the seedlings to the main field. In soils with low permeability, drainage channels are to be constructed to prevent water stagnation in upper layer of soil. With reference to the age of the seedlings at the time of transplanting, the best time of transplanting into the field is at the beginning of the main rainy season to give young palms time to form a good root system before the next dry season arrives. It is advisable to plant well-grown seedlings of 12 to 14 months old. At this stage, a well-developed tenera seedling will have a height of 1 to 1.3 meter from base and will have more than 13 functional leaves. These seedlings maintain higher leaf production, bear earlier, produce heavy bunches, give higher fruit bear punch ratio and a higher oil to mesocarp in the first year of harvest. Oil palm is commonly planted 9 meter apart in a triangular pattern, giving 143 plants per hectare. Now, we will see the training and pruning requirement of oil palm. The leaf pruning. Severe pruning will adversely affect both growth and yield of palm, cause abortion of female flowers and also reduce the size of the leaves. Hence, it is suggested that palms aged 4 to 7 years should retain 6 to 7 leaves per spiral, say 48 to 56 leaves totally. Those aged between 18 to 40 years should have 5 to 6 leaves per spiral, that means 40 to 49 total number of leaves, and those above 15 leaves should have 4 to 5 leaves per spiral, say 30 to 40 leaves totally. Now, we will see the water, nutrient and weed management in oil palm. Yielding palm of 3 years age and above requires a minimum of 150 liters of water daily. Drip irrigation. So, here 5 hours of irrigation per day using 4 drippers per palm at the rate of 8 liters of water per hour per dripper is usually practiced. Manuring. For 5-year-old palm, 50 kg of compost or farmyard manure or green leaves may be applied. Then, fertilizer schedule involves nitrogen in the form of urea, phosphorus, single superphosphate, potash, muriate of potash, and magnesium in the form of magnesium sulfate, boron in the form of borax is generally recommended. In the first year, 1250 grams of nitrogen, 670 gram of phosphorus, 125 gram of potash and 25 gram of magnesium is recommended per palm per year. In the second year, it is increased to 1740 gram of nitrogen, 2500 grams of phosphorus, 1340 grams of potash and 250 grams of magnesium is given. Then third year, it is again increased to 2610 grams of nitrogen, 3750 grams of phosphorus, 2000 grams of potash and 500 grams of magnesium and 100 gram of borax are recommended. These are usually given in 2 equal split doses during July, August and December, January to have better fertilizer use efficiency. Then special horticulture practices we will see. Ablation. Ablation is the removal of male and female flowers produced in the early stage of pollination. This enables the plant to gain adequate stem girth, vigor and develop adequate root system. Flowering starts from 14th to 18 months after planting. Start ablation immediately after the appearance of the inflorescence on the palms. They can be removed easily by hand pulling. Ablation can be extended up to 2.5 to 3 years depending upon the plant growth and vigor. Then pollination. Oil palm is a highly cross-molded crop. Wind and insects assist pollination. Effective pollinating insects like helps in the good pollination and fruit set. Release of some of the weevils after 2 to 2.5 years of planting is advisable for increasing the pollination efficiency. If the plants are not having good girth and vigor, release of the weevils only after third year. Insect pollination in oil palm. The weevil in the oil palm plantations of Kerala was introduced during the year 1985. The weevils are dark brown in color. Adult weevils feed on the anther filaments. Eggs are deposited inside the male flowers and larva feeds on the spent flowers. Life cycle is completed within 11 to 13 days. Males live longer than females. The activity of the insect is in accordance with the receptivity of the male and female inflorescence. It was roughly estimated that 40 palms in a grove might be the minimum to sustain a sufficiently high continuous population of pollinators to pollinate. The weevils carry maximum pollen during the third day of anthesis. Antenna, rostrum, thorax, legs, etc. of the insect are the main sites of pollen gland. This weevil is fairly good searching ability. It can survive in dry as well as in wet season. For introduction, male flowers cut from the palms which have the weevils are transferred to a plantation where one wishes to introduce after making sure that they are not carrying any plant pathogens or diseases. Now we will see the plant growth regulation in palm. The palms are very tall, 7.5 to 20 meter tall it will attain. They are erect, heavy trunks, ringed, and they are monoecious. Male and female flowers are born in the separate clusters but on the same plant, same tree. Trunk grows up to 20 meter tall, usually less than 30 centimeter in diameter. Leaf base adhere. Petioles 1.3 to 2.3 meter long, 12.5 to 20 centimeter wide, sawtooth, broadened at base, fibrous green, blade pinnate 3.3 to 5 meter long with 100 to 150 pairs of leaflets. Leaflets 60 to 1 centimeter long, 3.5 to 5 centimeter broad. Central rachis is very strong, especially at base, green on both surfaces. Flower stalks from lower leaf axils, 10 to 30 centimeter long and broad. Male flowers on short furry branches, 10 to 15 centimeter long, set close to trunk on short pedicels. Female flowers and consequently fruit in large clusters of 200 to 300 close to the trunk on short heavy pedicels. Each fruit plum like ovoid to oblong in shape, 3.5 centimeter long and about 2 centimeter wide. Black when ripe, red at base with thick ivory whitish flesh and a small cavity in center, nuts encased in a fibrous covering which contains the oil. About 5 female inflorescences are produced per year, each inflorescence weighing about 8 kg, the fruit weighing about 3.5 gram each. Some of the important disorders are, the nursery seedlings are affected by a number of fungal diseases, which however can be controlled by cultural and fungicide treatments. The most important ones are anthracnose, which is caused by glomerula species, seedling blight caused by Carolaria species. In respect of the pest, most important one is the rhinoceros beetle, which also attacks the coconut. The adults bore through the basal parts of the leaves into the top of the growing point of the palm and enter the heart of the unfolded leaves or center spike, working downwards. The youngest expanded leaves die off and the leaves in the central bud generally unfold, showing triangular cuts on each side of the central rib. Eggs are laid in the soft growing point. The larva feed on the younger tissues and top part of the palm, the whole of the center of the top being usually eaten away. To control this, spray lambdacyclopterin at the rate of 0.015% or using biocontrol agent like metarhizium. The low cost eco-friendly technology is this through the biocontrol agent and which will easily control this. And the fermented castor cake solution can be also used as a eco-friendly method for successful and viable method of control of this beetle. Cycate, here this moderate defoliation, that is 10 to 13% can cause a yield decline of around 30 to 40% over 2 years due to decrease in the rate of photosynthesis. So, control measures, spray monocotophos at the rate of 0.036% or quinolphos 0.05%. Then mask tapping using pheromones is also successful in controlling this insect. Next is the slug caterpillar. The caterpillar is greenish brown in color with broad anterior and narrow posterior. It has tiny branches of minute hairs all over the body. Fully grown larvae feed on the leaf blades. The larva feed by scraping the green leaf tissues. This causes drying and holes start appearing on the dried portion subsequently. Affected leaf fronds show a burnt appearance, and in the case of severe attack, whole tree looks dry. To control this, remove the affected leaves in the lower rows. Spray dichlorovas at 0.2% or quinalfos 0.05% or lambdocyclothrin 0.015% and use bevraria as a biological control agent. Rodents, that is rats, also cause damage to the roots, apical buds and fruits. Control measures, zinc phosphate or bromelain as a bait, we can control it. In respect of diseases, bunch rot caused by the fungus Marsifamiorus is a serious one, and the control measures involve spraying of garmentisum at the rate of 0.1%. Basal stem rot caused by the fungus Ganoderma, which causes high losses, especially when replanting land previously under coconut or oil palm. Infection takes place through root contact with the decaying stem and roots. Control measure involves complete removal of all stems and roots before replanting, removal of the diseased palms from the plantation, root feeding with 10 ml of calyxin or tridomorph in 100 ml of water. The next disease, namely bud rot, drenching the ground with 0.1% carbendazim solution and topical application of carbendazim paste in the spindle cluster region after doing surgery or removal of the rotten tissues. Now we will see the maturity indices and harvest. Oil palm starts bearing from 4th year onwards, and its economic life varies from 25 to 30 years. Harvesting is an important operation which decides the quality and quantity of oil to a great extent. If underripe branches are harvested, oil content will be less and recovery will be poor. Harvesting indices for oil palm are fruits in bunches turn yellowish orange, natural dropping of 5 to 10 fruits from each bunch, exudation of orange yellow colored oil on pressing of the fruit with fingers. While harvesting, care should be taken that stalk length should be less than 5 cm. A sharp chisel attached to iron rod is enough for harvesting the bunches in a young plantation. However, for adult palms of more than 8 feet height, harvesting knife fitted to aluminium or iron pole can be used. Lightweight telescopic harvesting poles are available for harvesting oil palm bunches. The yield of oil palm varies according to the age and management. Each palm may produce 5 to 12 bunches per year, each having around 2000 fruits. The average fruit weight is about 25 kg. Under average management condition in a mature plantation, say 8 to 9 years old, and yield of 15 to 18 tons of fresh fruit bunches per hectare can be easily obtained. With reference to the frequency of harvesting, harvesting rounds should be made as frequent as possible to avoid over-ripening of the bunches. A bunch which is almost ripe but not ready for harvest for a particular harvesting round should not be overripe by next round. In lean period of production, harvesting can be made less frequent, and it should be more frequent in peak periods. Harvesting round of 7 to 14 days are generally practiced. Other factors determining frequency are extraction capacity of the mill, transportation facilities, labor availability and skill of the workers. Now we will see the post-harvest management of oil palm. Fresh fruit bunches, which is called FFB, of oil palm are highly perishable and should be processed within 24 hours after harvesting. Delay in processing adversely affects the quality due to increase in free fatty acid content and quantity of palm oil. Oil palm marketing in the country is well streamlined, earmarking plantation zones for each palm oil mill. Most of the factories have established collection centers at various locations for procurement of fresh fruit bunches. In many of the states like Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Mizoram, Goa, oil palm plantation act has been enacted, which mandates the palm oil mills to buy FFB produced by the oil palm growers or their cooperative societies in their factory zone at a price not less than the price fixed by the price fixation committee. At the same time, the oil palm growers are also under an obligation to supply the fresh fruit bunches from oil palm plantation in that area only to the factory or the mill to whom the factory zone is attached. Palm oil mills, large or small, process fresh fruit bunches FFB to oil and kernel through a well-defined stages, sterilizing the FFB with steam under pressure to loosen the fruits, destroy the lipolytic enzymes lipase to arrest free fatty acid formation and to kill all microorganisms, stripping the fruits from the bunches, digesting the fruits and reheating of the macerated mix of pulp and the nuts, extracting the oil by hydraulic or double screw process, clarifying to remove the water and sludge from the oil in continuous clarification tanks or by centrifugal separation and drying. Then storing of crude palm oil in tanks before transport for further refining and processing. Nuts are separated from the press cake, dried, graded and fed to centrifugal crackers to remove the shell. Kernels are extracted for the oil in separate mills locally or abroad by methods similar to those used for copra. Palm oil for soap manufacturing is manually extracted from macerated fruits which have been allowed to ferment in pits for several days. Oil extraction efficiency of the traditional method is low, say less than 50%, and free fatty acid content is about 6 to 10% even in edible palm oil. To sum up, the highest oil yielding perennial palm is known as palm fruit oil also. It comes from mesocarp, that is the flesh of the fruit, and the palm kernel oil is from the kernel of the seed. Palm kernel oil has two components, palm kernel olein and solid component palm kernel stearin. Palm oil is rich in carotenoids, provitamin A, tocotrienol and tocopherols, and it contains no trans fatty acids. Climate with temperature of 21 to 32 degree with the annual rainfall of about 200 centimeter and late humidity ranging from 75 to 100% is suitable. It grows well with an altitude of about 450 to 900 meter above mean sea level. Soil type of moist, deep, loamy, rich in humus with water permeability are highly suitable. pH 4 to 6 is ideal. There are three varieties, Dura, Tenera and Piscifera. Practically all planted oil palms are Dura into Piscifera hybrids. Propagation is through seed only. Total duration of both nursery stages before transplanting to the field is about 10 to 14 months. Oil palm is commonly planted 9 meter apart in a triangular pattern, giving about 143 plants per hectare. One palm requires about 200 to 250 liters of water every day. Flowering starts from 14th to 18th months after planting, and at this stage start ablation after the appearance of the inflorescence on the palms. Ablation can be extended up to 2.5 to 3 years depending upon the plant growth and vigor. Oil palm is a highly cross-pollinated crop. Wind and insect assist in pollination. Oil palm starts bearing from 4th year onwards and its economic life varies from 25 to 30 years. Harvesting indices for oil palm are fruits in bunches turn yellowish orange in color, natural dropping of 5 to 10 fruits from each bunch, exudation of orange yellow colored oil on pressing of the fruit with fingers.